the turning point, a fork stuck in the road. Time grabs you by the wrist, directs you where to go. So make the best of this test and don't ask why. It's not a question but a lesson learned in time. It's something unpredictable, but in the end is right. I hope you had the time of your life. So take the photographs and still frames in your mind, hanging on a shelf in good health and good time. Tattoos and memories and dead skin on trial. For what it's worth, it was worth all the while. It's something unpredictable, but in the end is right. I hope you had the time of your life. But in the end it's right. I hope you had the time of your life. It's something unpredictable, but in the end it's right. I hope you had the time of your life.
When you take that jump, you don't feel the fall. Hope when the water rises, you built a wall. Hope when the crowd screams out, you're screaming your name. Hope if everybody runs, you choose to stay. You fall in love and it hurts so bad. Hope when the moment comes,
auspiciousness and causes of success. May you have the confidence to always do your best. May you take no effort in your being generous, sharing what you can, nothing more, nothing less. May you know the meaning of the word happiness. May you always lead from the beating in your chest. May you be treated like an esteemed guest. May you get to rest, may you catch your breath. May the best of your todays be the worst of your tomorrows. Whoa. May the road less paved be the road that you follow. Whoa. Well, here's to the hearts that you're gonna break. Here's to the lives that you're gonna change. Here's to the infinite possible ways to love you. I want you to have it. Here's to the good times we're gonna have. You don't need money, you got a free pass. Here's to the fact that I'd be sad without you. You to have it all. Slap bracelet. May you keep the chaos and the clutter off your desk. May you have unquestionable health and less stress. Having no possessions, though immeasurable wealth. May you get a gold star on your next test. May your educated guesses always be correct. And may you win prizes shining like diamonds. May you really own it each moment to the.
Ladies and gentlemen, family and friends, in just a few minutes, we invite you to celebrate with us the spring 2022. Nursing graduates. As the lights dim and the ceremony begins, we ask that you please take your seats and silence your cell phones. We hope you will enjoy this celebration of our wonderful graduating class. Graduates, please prepare to begin the ceremony. Thank you.
Your path is.
If everybody runs, you choose to stay. Hope that you fall in love, and it hurts so bad. When you take that jump, you don't feel the fall. Hope when the water rises, you built a wall. Hope when the crowd screams out, you're screaming your name. Hope if everybody runs, you choose to stay. You fall in love and it hurts so bad.
I did it all.
Hello, everyone. My name is Timothy Nelson, the president of the Valley Student Nurses Association, and I'm honored to be your host for this evening. Family and friends, I want to welcome you to the Spring 2022 Nurse Pinning Ceremony. Now, before we begin, please be aware that we have a professional photographer that's going to be capturing pictures of your graduates at the back of the auditorium. So we ask that you please remain seated as to not get in his field of view. Now, this is going to be a wonderful night full of laughter and fun. There may be a few tears, but for the most part, it'll be a night full of congratulations, admiration, and love for these exceptional individuals. Graduates, you've done a fantastic job, and I am absolutely blessed to have the honor to follow in your footsteps. So without further ado, please join me in welcoming Professor Obra for our invocation.
Thank you, team. Good evening, everyone. Good evening. So again, I am Professor Violi Obra. And guess what, guys? It is a great honor to start this celebration with a special invocation. So you may bow your heads for an opening prayer. God of glory, we are gathered here tonight to celebrate the pinning ceremony, and with this celebration, we greatly praise you, honor you, and glorify you. Thank you, Heavenly Father, for bringing us safely together tonight, families, friends, faculties, and the graduate nurses. Thank you. Thank you, Heavenly Father, for the God-sized blessings that you showered each of these gifted and talented, loving, caring, and compassionate nursing graduates. You have, as promised, remain at their side, providing comfort, providing guidance, wisdom, and strength throughout the program, especially for the past unprecedented years, 2 years. For you said, I have good plans for you, plans to prosper you and not to harm you. I will give you hope and good future. And as they move on to the next level of their career, the preparation, the NCLEX, the job hunting, strengthen their faith, their hope, trust, and love in you, that they may always serve you, help them to always focus their hearts, their minds, their thoughts on you, on your divine direction, your divine guidance and plan. For you said, seek first the kingdom of God, and all these other things will be given unto you. Heavenly Father, thank you also for your continuous blessings to their families and friends who have patiently sacrificed, greatly supported, and most of all, loved them unconditionally as they went through the program. And for the faculties and staffs, thank you, Lord, for blessing them with love, patience, and compassion, wisdom, knowledge, and skills. Thank you that they are able to serve you through helping, guiding and caring for our future RNs. For you said, in all we do, we will do for your honor and glory. Look upon this meeting ceremony with great favor. Be with each nurse graduates as they receive their nursing pins, symbol of their accomplishment, of their completion of the registered nursing program. Surround us now with your guardian angels, with happy Holy Spirit. Completely cover us all with your perfect love, your perfect joy and peace as we continue our celebration. May the memories of tonight be sweet and lasting and pleasing in your sight. On behalf of the graduates, the future RNs, this we pray in your most holy name. Amen. Congratulations, graduates.
Thank you, Professor Obra. That was beautiful. On behalf of San Bernardino Valley College, I would like to invite our interim president, Dr. Scott Thayer, to the stage.
Wow, this is my favorite time of year. I'll start with that. You know, as we get a chance to celebrate the successes. So welcome, everyone. My name is Scott Thayer, and I am so delighted to greet you on this beautiful evening as we gather together to celebrate our amazing nursing graduates. This celebration is a culmination of so much hard work on the part of our students, and I am privileged to be joining our faculty, graduates, and you all, the family members, to acknowledge and celebrate them for embarking on this path as a healthcare professional. Each of our graduates has had their own remarkable journey to this moment, but one thing unites all of you. You have all worked very hard to be here today. As nurses, you embody some of the most admirable qualities known to humankind. You embody compassion. You embody selflessness. You embody the desire to save lives and help others. And we are so proud as educators to have been part of your educational journey and can't wait to see you thrive in the healthcare profession. Thank you, students, for demonstrating that there is nothing that can stop you from moving forward. Thank you for aspiring towards success, for working hard, for taking advantage of opportunities, and for inspiring us as educators. I would also like to thank our amazing faculty for their commitment to student success and help, and for helping our students reach their academic goals. Let us also thank you, the family members and friends of our graduates. Thank you for supporting our students as they pursued their dreams and for believing in them. You are the reason many of them are here today. Let us show some appreciation for our students, our instructors, our families and friends. Can we get a round of applause for the graduates of 2022? You know, at this time, it is my pleasure, and if I'm going off, I was going to introduce our dean, if that's okay. If not, I'll pass it back. But I'd like to introduce a person who's done some great work, the Dean of Sciences, Dr. John Stanskis, to continue tonight's program. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Dr. Thayer. Can we start with the audience and then we'll come back to you? Because you're the most important. I don't want you to think you're not. But can we start with all those people out there who have supported you, who have sacrificed with you, who have seen you cry? Yes. Who have seen you come back from a rotation at a hospital, exhausted, and drag yourself in and open that book? Yeah, can we start by just standing up and clapping for them? Thank you. And they clearly love you and support you and are so proud of you. And the other people out there, your faculty and staff, who have guided you and helped you and sometimes challenged you, yeah, a little. Don't lie. Yes, they did. And they did that because they care about you too, because they are invested in you and your future. And so can we give them a hand too? Now we're done with them. You all have sacrificed for years. Haven't you? It's not just a two-year program. You took anatomy, physiology, microbiology. Was that fun? You took some chemistry. You took all of your general education requirements. You invested all of that time in you. And hopefully, obviously, you believe you're worth it. And all these people out here believe you're worth it. And on Wednesday morning, you're going to pick up a diploma that no one can ever take away from you. It is an accomplishment that is yours. And we are so proud of you to send you out representing San Bernardino Valley College as the class of 2022 and our graduating nurses. And we are here. When you get bored and you want to come back and pick up a clinical rotation in a couple years, we're here. We would love to have you back on your journey. But today, remember that all these people in this room care about you, support you, and love you, and that you are worth it as we move into the future. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much for those inspiring words, Dr. Stanskis. Next, on behalf of the nursing department, please put your hands together in welcoming our wonderful Associate Dean of Health Sciences and the Director of the Nursing Department, Yolanda Simmental.
Good evening, everyone. It is my honor to be the Associate Dean of Health Science and Director of Nursing, and nothing makes me prouder. I love this program. I am an alumni of this program. So, yes, I am here for the program and for you, our graduates. But why are we here? Congratulations to the family. Yes, you have sacrificed. Congratulations to our graduates. But this is the pinning ceremony. And the pinning ceremony is a ceremony of achievement and completion. And so what is the symbolism? It's a long tradition here at San Bernardino Valley College. And so the symbolism is reflected back to Florence Nightingale. We just saw the candle lighting ceremony. And that represents, back to Florence Nightingale, the lighting of the candle, because she has to care for the soldiers by candlelight, right? So that's a symbolism that we just saw. The graduates will also recite the Florence Nightingale Pledge at the end of the ceremony. And this pledge was written by Florence Nightingale. Awarding of the pin, you will receive a pin, a special pin. It is unique to San Bernardino Valley College. That is also something that goes back to Florence Nightingale. She herself received a pin by Queen Victoria, and it was an award because of everything she did. And then she continued the tradition with her graduates of her nursing school. So tonight, we continue that tradition. And the San Bernardino Valley College nursing pin that you will receive is a reminder of your accomplishments. As we've said already, the hours you have spent studying, the sacrifices you have made, the parties you've missed, the evenings with your children that you've missed, all that. But I want you to remember that this pin symbolizes those sacrifices. And most importantly, always cherish your San Bernardino Valley College pin, because it symbolizes the bond that you have created as a class and with each other. And even though you're gonna have a beautiful nursing career, your nursing career will take you to many places, but that pin will always connect you here at Valley College. So wear your pin and treasure it proudly, and let it bring back the wonderful memories that you had and the friendships you made here at Valley College. So congratulations again. Thank you.
Thank you, Interim President Thayer, Dean Stanskis, and Director Simmental, for your kind, thoughtful words and ever sage advice. Now, I would like to welcome the graduates Alina Calderon and Nikki Garcia to introduce the San Bernardino Valley College Administrative Nursing Team.
Join us as we welcome Interim President Dr. Scott Thayer. Can you please stand up? Thank you. Dean of Science Division Dr. John Stanskis. Associate Dean of Health Sciences, Director of Nursing, Yolanda Semmental. Our full-time nursing faculty, we would like to welcome Professor Anita Arnold. Professor Esprit Foscolos. Dr. Reshmi Kapitel. Professor Violi Obra. Professor Mary Rascone. Professor Deborah Trusha. And Professor Angela Vogel. And also our staff, Miriam Malika. And Miss Robin Bender. And also all of the adjunct faculty, can you please stand up?
Thank you.
Thank you all.
Thank you, ladies. Now, to recognize these magnificent instructors, please join me in welcoming the graduates Jesse Purcell, Tanya Borquez, Joseph Hammond, Norma Perez, and Tanya Silva.
family and friends. My name is Jesse Purcell. I've been tasked with the opportunity to speak about our first semester and our instructors. In preparation for today, I first wanted to talk, I wanted to talk a lot about the negatives or things I didn't love during our first semester. And then I was going to use those and switch into how those things that I didn't love led us to be being more resilient and able to push through tough times. But to try and stay focused on positives, I won't spend time on pointing out those things that I didn't love about first semester. Things like dreadful 12-hour days on a computer chair, or how awkward it was making a head-to-toe assessment video with my wife, or how terrified I was of proctorial kicking me off my exam, or those wretched Keith RN case studies that we had to do. I won't focus on those. I'll try to focus on the positives. To Professor Hill and Professor T, thank you so much for your tough love through our first semester. You kept the bar high and pushed us to be better. You helped facilitate changing our mindset to that of an RN. You kept us excited about nursing school. I remember the first day of lecture, I woke up early, had a nice breakfast, put on that wonderful blue clinical, or not clinical, but lab shirt that we had. Got in my car, drove to my grandma's house, sat at the desk, and turned on Zoom. It wasn't how I thought the nursing program would go, but we pushed through. I believe that our first semester helped bring us closer when we finally got to be together for clinical and class. I know for me, it pushed me to communicate with my cohort for help and advice to get through. I think that for most of us, our dedication to nursing school and our excitement to finish grew after the first semester. It gave us a little taste of what it would be like to be an RN. I can't believe how fast time has gone. It seems like not too long ago we were finishing up our first semester with that super awkward Christmas party. I'm grateful for the challenges that first semester presented. I feel that overcoming those challenges shows our ability to adapt to trying situations, to push ourselves, and to stay dedicated. First semester was definitely a whirlwind, but I'm glad and grateful for the lessons learned. Thank you.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Tanya Borquez, and I have been tasked with talking a little bit about the experience of being in the LVN to RN bridge program that we have here. So many of us know what it's like as a child to come into a new school, a new class, in the middle of a school year. Whether we had just moved or switched classes, it was always scary and really nerve-wracking. Well, surprisingly, the feeling and emotion of that experience doesn't change much even as an adult. Those of us that started this nursing program in the LVN to RN bridge program came into a cohort that had already been together. Bonds had already started to be formed, and friendships had already been developed. So it was normal for us to be nervous. That sort of experience can be very intimidating, but for us, it was just the opposite. Everyone that we encountered welcomed us with open arms and pulled us into the group. We were made to feel like we had been there from the beginning, and not that we were the new kids in class. So I say thank you to my classmates for making us feel welcomed and that we always belonged. We appreciate it so much. We were a part of the family from the very beginning, and now there's no getting rid of us. I have many friends that I will hold with me for a lifetime. Going back to school after already working many years in healthcare was one of the scariest things I know I had ever done. I wanted to further my education, grow and move up within the healthcare field, and though it took me a while, it was something I always wanted to accomplish, to earn my RN degree. Life never affords you the right time to go back to school, but most things in life that we strive for never seems like the perfect time. Life doesn't work that way. Most times you just have to jump in and start. So that's what we did. That's what many of us did. Some of us being older students, you feel like you may need to prove yourself a little bit more. For the LVNs, we collectively felt that we wanted to also help our classmates with anything that we could. We had a vast amount of knowledge to share, and we were encouraged to do so by our professors. We heard those words from many of the faculty, to share what we knew, to share our experiences, share those tips and tricks we had learned while working, and help those others along the way. And we tried our best to do that. I'd also like to extend a special thank you to all of our instructors. All of our instructors, those that are still part of the department, and those that have moved on to new adventures. Our cohort shares an experience that no other class can say that they have. Our entire nursing school was through the course of a pandemic, and there have been obstacles that no one else has had. This doesn't just apply to the students, but also to the professors and the adjunct faculty. They were also facing something that had never happened in their lifetime, no matter how long they had been an educator or even a nurse. Adjustments and changes were made weekly, daily even, and we all had to adapt and roll with the punches. In dealing with these unique circumstances, we leaned on each other more, worked harder together, and accomplished so much. We can always look back at on this time and be proud of ourselves and know that we made it to the finish line. Thank you.
Good evening once again. My name is Joseph Hammond, and I'll be summarizing our experience in the second semester. Also, what a beautiful sight we have tonight. Congratulations to all my colleagues. Good evening, everyone, and thanks for gracing our occasion. School was still closed for in-person lectures, so we had to continue with online education. It was a wake-up call for those of us who have managed to scale the first semester well, which wasn't very easy. Second semester gave us the opportunity to appreciate the virtual resources that we had, but have not seen their usefulness. Some of us became very good with online school, which was initially not part of our school life. Imagine delivering babies via internet. That was our initiation to the second semester. And I said, welcome to the COVID era of baby delivery, 21st century technology. But we made it thanks to Dr. Capital, Professor DiMarco, and Professor Shepherd. They are wonderful and have done a yeoman's job in training us to be proficient, despite all the hurdles that we had to go through. We can assess and teach mothers to take care of their newborn babies without any physical contact. Thank you, Dr. Capital. Next came MedSage and Professor Eastman, Professor Paget, and Professor Rascon. Thank you very much. Another healthy dose of care plans came our way, but at least we got to know how to assess for GI, respiratory, and neurological defects. Again, virtually, but we made it. Thank you, Professor Eastman, thank you, Professor Paget, and thank you, Professor Rascon. We will forever remain indebted to you all. We were able to scale the tall walls of second semester because we stood on the shoulders of giants like you to the next rotation. Thank you once again, and God richly bless you.
Hi. First of all, congratulations to the new nursing graduates. We did it. My name is Nora Perez, and I was asked to speak on behalf of our third semester. Third semester officially marks our halfway through of becoming a nurse. Third semester consisted of MedSearch and pediatrics. In MedSearch, we had Professor T, who had the patience to teach us everything we needed to know about the cardiac, dysrhythmias, blood transfusions, therapy, hormones, and et cetera. Until last week, those cardiac strips continued to haunt us because they haunt us to fourth semester. I guess from here on, it will continue hunting us. And let's not mention those annoying, long, never-ending care plans. Now for pediatrics. Man, I remember how scared we were to go into that class. Peds, the word of peds just terrified us. Professor Violi, you really made us sweat. But we learned so much about children's growth development. And let's not forget the Erikson's and Paget's theories. When I think of Pete's and Professor Violi, all that comes to mind is the Kahoot theme song and her cheerful voice saying, good job, good job. And there we were, everyone racing to be in first place. And of course, Ashley and Matt were always first. Another memory was our Pete's clinical rotation, where we had the opportunity to go to Loma Linda University Medical Center and do the night shift rotation. Going to Loma Linda was a wonderful experience because we had a great clinical instructor, Oscar. who also works at Loma Linda Hospital, and he guided us through every disease process we can think of with pediatrics. I have to say that I always looked forward to every clinical rotation we had to do with him, because he shared his knowledge as he walked us through the PICU. He explained to us all the signs and symptoms, all the conditions, all the functions of the monitors that we still didn't understand. His motivation in teaching us made everything so understandable. No matter how dumb the question we had, he made us feel comfortable, and he answered whatever question we asked. And to that, we say thank you, Oscar. And all I have to say to the third semester that are here, everything, it's going to be good. Enjoy every moment you have, because it's going to fly by. Next thing you know, you will be sitting here like we are and giving a speech to the upcoming third semester. I am not telling you it's going to be easy, because it's not. I'm telling you it's going to be worth it. Never give up on a dream just because of the time it's going to take you to accomplish it. The time will pass by anyways, and you will get there before you know it. Thank you.
Good evening, fellow graduates, faculty, friends, and family. My name is Tanya Silva, and I have the privilege of sharing about our fourth semester experiences. This semester is the semester we have been looking forward to for more than 2 years. We were so excited to begin our final semester. For those of us that started in critical care, we got to put our lovely white uniforms back on, and we headed out. When we got there and we read our first syllabus, we were petrified. Some of us were determined that we were not going to make it through nursing school because of Professor Vogel. Come to find out, it was more like football. She gave us hell week, and then by week two, we all started to breathe again. For critical care, some of us were really scared, and some of us were really excited to begin our clinicals in the ICU. Unfortunately, as a pandemic student nurse, we missed out on a lot of our impersonal clinical hours, and now we were headed into the hospital to do clinicals with the sickest patients in the hospital. Thankfully, we had some amazing clinical instructors. Thank you, Sarah. And nursing staff that brought us up to speed and helped us all connect the dots from fundamentals to med-surg and finally to our ICU. Professor Vogel showed us her passion for ICU, especially her cardiovascular passion, and helped us navigate the cardiac system and the types of shock. This was the first time many of us faced night shift clinicals, which was quite a challenge for most of us. However, we quickly learned that we had an advantage over day shift clinicals because the physicians, visitors, and others were not present. So there was a lot more time for us to do our tasks, learn more, ask questions, practice our skills, and even observe surgeries. For the other half of the cohort, they started in mental health or psych nursing. Once again, half of the class was excited or really nervous to begin clinicals at the psych facility. But every last one of us was happy to ditch our white uniforms and to be wearing our black and blues. One of my classmates refers to our white uniforms as the Stay Puffed Marshmallow Man from Ghostbusters, which is a pretty accurate description for most of us when we're wearing our whites. Anyhow, psych nursing seemed it was going to be an easy breezy, worry-free class until we realized we were going to have to do face-to-face clinicals at either ARMC, Behavioral Health, or Patton State Hospital. And then we got the syllabus and realized we also had to participate in Alcoholic Anonymous meetings and write two papers. Thanks, Professor Foskalos. She kept us focused by giving us an organized syllabus, and that coincided with her modules and her exams exactly. She also broke the learning time up with on-the-spot group activities and case studies, which were sometimes not so fun. But we learned a lot in our fourth semester, but most importantly, we finished our final semester. Congratulations. And we are now all nursing graduates. Congratulations to all of our class of 2022. It was a hard road, but we accomplished that in a blink of an eye, and we earned this.
Thank you, graduates, for sharing those beautiful experiences with all of us and giving us a little piece of what your journey was like over this long 2 years. And now, on behalf of the graduating class of 2022, please welcome the class speaker, Sylvia Guerrero.
Thank you. Hi, Presley. Okay, hello, good afternoon to the family, friends, and loved ones, and those that are watching on the live stream that came to support the graduating class of 2022. My name is Sylvia Guerrero, and it has been an absolute honor to be part of the same cohort as you all. The last 2 years have passed by unbelievably fast. By the time we got a chance to stop and breathe, the next quarter was already starting. When we received our acceptance letter, I'm sure we all thought, geez, 2 years, you know? That seemed like forever, right? That was 728 days ago. But when you think about it, that time was going to pass by regardless. What we did during that time is what makes us stand out. We had 728 days and we were determined. It would have never been possible without the love, the support from our families, our friends, and most importantly, from you guys, my nursing brothers and sisters. We made friendships that I hope will last a lifetime and bonds that cannot be broken. Alone, it seemed impossible, but the fact that we had each other made it a little bit more manageable. Throughout the duration of the program, many of us have faced challenges. From COVID, saying goodbye to loved ones, welcoming new ones, some got engaged, some got married, some of us even faced divorce. While we were fighting something we knew nothing about, no matter what happened to us through all the trials and tribulations, we made it. Yes, we may have missed some parties or stayed up way too late to study, but we indefinitely drank a lot of caffeine. That was only a small price to pay for our future. Throughout the duration of this program, we have came across some of the best, most amazing nurses, our professors. You all have been respectful, helpful, and went out of your way to make sure that we thrived. Most importantly, you advocated for us as students to get the knowledge that we needed. You guys taught us the importance of communication, because during the time that we were going through our struggles, you guys helped us get through them so that we can make it to this day. So on behalf of the class, we deeply thank you for everything you've done to us, for us. Your actions and your knowledge were more powerful than you'll ever know. To the class, we have come a long way when you think about it. When we first met, we were on our two-inch little Zoom squares. Some of us were on an island, a virtual island, in virtual classrooms, virtual space. But when we finally got to meet each other in person after Zoom, it was kind of weird seeing each other in full size, right? We connected. We felt like we knew each other. We started, you know, like Jesse said, we did head to toes on, honestly, whoever was home at that time. We were able to, till now, we can practice on real patients. I remember getting the cutest nursing planner one Christmas. Thanks, Natasha. I entered all my assignments in, all the due dates for everything we had to do, and the joy that I had crossing everything off as the weeks went by, knowing I was that much closer to this day. That was 32 exams later, countless clinical hours later, and everything we went through. Like all good things, this must come to an end. But with the end is a new beginning of a beautiful life for us. We must now write the pages of our future with the tools that were provided for us. Faculty, you have done all you had to do to provide us with the skill set and the power to become competent and safe nurses. This is our time to shine. This is our time to get out there and show the world and prove to ourselves though no matter what we are faced with in this life, we will adapt, we will thrive, and we will succeed. And we will have those two initials at the end of our name, RN. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Sylvia, for your words of inspiration. At this time, I would like to introduce our faculty speaker, the one and only Professor Angela Vogel.
Welcome, faculty, administrators, students, family, friends, and wonderful supporters of our graduate nurses. And finally, the stars of our ceremony here, the graduate class of spring 2022. Thank you so much for the opportunity to speak at this very celebration of your accomplishment. My name is Angie Vogel, and I've had the pleasure of participating in the education and development of this class of very accomplished students. I have been instructing the fourth semester of critical care nursing, and although you've already heard that apparently I greeted them with a syllabus that instilled fear and even some loathing, I can honestly admit that I too had an amount of fear because this was my first time getting to teach critical care nursing, which is my passion and has been for a very long time. So again, thank you for the opportunity to have been involved. I was striving to make an impact and to challenge their learning with the ultimate goal of igniting a passion within each of them to become a critical care nurse, but a nurse that they would reflect on and be very proud of. This class, in my eyes, had conquered so many obstacles, a lot of which you have heard about, and I knew we would face some more this semester. Let me trace back for you the praises that every one of these students should wear as a badge of honor today. In the summer of 2020, the world had closed. Many families were facing loss of jobs, loss of peace of mind, and some even loss of family and friends. These students were receiving an invitation to come and test for a spot in the next class here at Valley College. And a few weeks later, they received a congratulations to join this class. And they were lining up to experience nursing in a pandemic. They set off on this career and they pledged to be the next on the front line during a turbulent time in nursing, and for this I applaud you. Next came the goal of starting nursing school. They all expected that it would be hard, but I'm sure none of them ever expected that it would be online. These students face some of the most difficult content in education at home, distracted by maybe some of you, and the fears that everybody was facing because the world was changing around us. They had no physical contact with a lot of their classmates or instructors. It took them a while to build the tribes that they've talked about and build the bonds that they have built. And all of this intensified the difficulty. But they endured and they conquered it. Finally, third semester, they were consistently back to clinicals and they were feverishly catching up on those real patient experiences that a simulator or Zoom really just does not do justice to. And then came fourth semester. The fourth term in critical care, there was honestly not a patient that I could give them that did not have COVID. But in a pandemic and with a goal of preparation, this was the absolute best experience for them to have. After all, you had enlisted to be part of the front line. Each class, I always start with a discussion of a student's why. Why here? Why now? Why do you want to be a nurse? I know that when times get tough, reflection on your why can sometimes get you through. It's always a great icebreaker for students to embrace the different paths that we may have all taken to get to this point. I'd actually like to highlight one of my students' whys because it was so relevant to the tough times we have faced in healthcare these past few years. Ashley Leeper stated, becoming a nurse, She was becoming a nurse because she was passionate about using her empathy towards others in combination with her passion for science to make a difference in people's lives. As faculty, I'm sure we would all love to say that we have prepared these students with everything that they will ever need to know to be a successful nurse. This pandemic has reminded us the unpredictability of medicine and epidemiology. It has proven to us the necessity of balancing a connected engagement to our patients and then the science behind the theories that we employ to make sure that they are safe. This class has seen firsthand the science of evidence-based practice with COVID and developed, as it's developed. And Ashley's statement in her discussion was an affirmation that the time that they have all been preparing for has come. The obstacles that they were faced were yours uniquely to be embraced. My hope and prayer for this graduating class is that they take these obstacles that they have conquered and they wear them like a badge of honor. Don't ever let anyone say that you were a pandemic nursing student as a letdown. That should be something that you embrace because you conquered something that no one else has during the time that they went to nursing school. They were successful in arguably the worst of times, and they built connectedness when we were also very vulnerable and isolated, and they have earned their nursing degree during the greatest pandemic of our lifetime. My heartfelt congratulations. May you continue to seek the science of nursing, and may your passion for learning grow more every day of your very long, long, long career. Thank you.
Thank you, Professor Vogel, for those words of wisdom. And now, for the moment that we have all been waiting for, please join me in welcoming back to the stage Professors Jenny Lindbergh and Oscar Vasquez Valdez to introduce our graduates, along with Dean Stanskis and Director Simmental, for the official awarding of the nursing pins.
Graduates, please prepare to receive your pins.
Alma Alcantara. Thank you, God, for giving me strength and passion to help others. I dedicate this achievement to my husband, Oscar, for being my rock through it all. Abby, I hope you are proud of mommy.
Brianne Bishop. I want to thank my husband, my family, and my friends for the love and support throughout this journey. When the road got rough, I knew I had you all to lean on. Special thanks to my nurse friends who quizzed me and offered their veins for practice.
Brianna Boites. I want to thank my parents, siblings, boyfriend, classmates, and instructors for your encouragement, support, love, prayers, and patience throughout this journey. And God, because without his grace and favor, I wouldn't be here today celebrating this dream of mine with you all. Look, you guys, I did it.
Tanya Borges. Thank you to my family for the continued support, my husband for always letting me know how proud he is, my children for being my motivation to keep going, and especially to my mother, who I would not have been able to accomplish anything without her. I love you all.
Rita Brazil. There is no point in pondering what could have been. The past only exists as a memory. The future is similarly just a figment of your imagination. Thus, the only moment of importance is this one right now. Be your wild, courageous, brilliant self every single day, no matter what.
Khadijah Brown. Thank you to my husband and kids for supporting me through this process. Here's to new beginnings. I love you guys.
Alina Calderon. A big thank you to all my family and friends for your support, unconditional love, and for always believing in me. I could not have done this without you. I love you all.
Cassandra Carpenter. I would like to thank my family for always being there for me and for always being so supportive of all my accomplishments and for always encouraging me to chase my dreams and to live my life to the fullest. I appreciate and love you all so much.
Kimberly Chavez. Thank you, God, for guiding me and giving me the strength to complete nursing school. Thank you to my friends and my family for the constant support, motivation, and unconditional love you guys have given me throughout this journey. I wouldn't have done it without you guys. I love you.
Yuruak Edim. Honor and glory to God for making this journey possible. I want to thank my family, especially Joy, for the support system, prayers, and encouragement. Thank you for believing in me that I would succeed. To my classmates, thank you for the support system of not leaving anyone behind.
Nikki Garcia. Firstly, thank you to God for the continuous blessings. Thank you to my family, my mom, dad, brothers, and sisters for the endless love and support. To my son, Aiden, I love you more than words can describe. To my angel in heaven, I hope I'm making you proud.
Yesenia Garibay. Gracias Dios por concederme este momento. A mi madre, hermana Paola y a mi esposo, gracias por estar allí en cada paso de mi camino. Gracias madre por tus oraciones y consejos durante mis luchas. Este logro te lo dedico a ti. Hannah and Caleb, mommy did this for you.
Matthew Gringas. I want to thank my parents and my amazing wife for supporting me throughout this journey. I have worked so hard for so long to get here, and I couldn't have done it without them. I love you guys.
Sylvia Guerrero. To mom and my daughter Presley, thank you for being my biggest cheerleaders. You've encouraged me to succeed in more ways than you'll ever know. I will always be forever grateful for my friends that have supported me, especially when it all seemed impossible. Class of 2022, we did it.
Joseph Hammond. I would like to thank God for seeing me through nursing school. I would also thank my wife for helping me to finish the program and to all who encouraged me in diverse ways to see this day. God richly bless you all.
Ni Hun. Nursing school friends are the best kind of friends. Thank you for pushing me to finish line, for wholeheartedly supporting me, and for sharing this moment of achievement with me. Congratulations again to all of us. We made it.
Xenia Kent. I want to thank God, mom, dad, sister, aunt, uncle, and late aunt for being the driving force. It's been a long, difficult journey, but we made it. I am proud of myself for fighting till the end. My heart is filled with gratitude and love. I want to thank my instructors for leading us.
Ashley Leeper. I wouldn't be here without the grace of God and the support of my loved ones. To my parents, thank you for believing in me even when I didn't believe in myself. I am blessed to have made it here, and I can't wait to see what the future holds.
Mario Lopez. First and foremost, I would like to praise and thank God for keeping me focused and calm throughout this program. I would also like to thank my mother, father, brother, and Maida for always being in my corner. I couldn't have done this without your unconditional support and love.
Jennifer Marks. I want to thank God for his unconditional blessings. To my grandmother, Jenny B, we made it. To my queen and king, my mom and dad, this wouldn't be impossible if it wasn't for you guys. Trey, you have been my heart. Candace and Deanne, I love you guys.
Veronica Martinez. Thank you very much to my family and friends, especially my in-laws for all their help and my children for their understanding and patience. But most of all, to my husband for all his support throughout my journey and helping me make my dream come true. I love you all.
Arian Ortega. I want to thank my family for teaching me the essence of perseverance while doing so with humility and grace. I dedicate this accomplishment to my mother and brothers, whose love gives me strength, and my father, who may no longer be with us, but always lives deeply in our hearts.
Valiant Asumo. This is dedicated first to the Almighty God for giving me the privilege and resilience to get this far. My special thanks to my wife and kids for their unflinching support, even when I felt the road was too hard. I acknowledge my NCUS colleagues. Thank you all.
Carol Ovalle. To my mom, dad, my sisters, Betsy, Erica, Natalie, Melanie, and Bella Boo, I'm forever grateful for you and all you do for me. My wonderful friends in nursing school, family, thank you for all the support. To my babies, Anaya and AJ, this is for you. Mommy loves you.
Nora Perez. Words cannot express what I am feeling right now. It has been the hardest journey, but I finally did it. Family, thank you for your support and encouragement. Mom, I love you. To my children, thank you for your patience and believing in me. This is for us.
Taryn Pruzak. Thanks to my family and friends who have supported me through the highs and lows of the past 2 years, especially Shane. You're my motivation, my support, and my best friend. I'm so lucky to share this achievement with you. Dad, this one's for you.
Jesse Purcell. I want to express my love and gratitude to my beautiful wife, our 3 children, and my family. I love you, and I am grateful for you. To my cohort, I couldn't have gotten through the program without you guys. Thanks for a great 2 years.
Jennifer Rodriguez. Thank you to my parents for always supporting me, especially through this nursing journey.
Reyna Ruiz. To my family, thank you for your endless love and support throughout this journey. To my boyfriend, Ryan, you are my biggest supporter. Thank you for encouraging me to get back to school years ago. I could not have done this without you. Yay, I did it.
Karina Serrano. Thank you, God, for giving me the strength and courage to keep going. To my husband, Joseph, you've been my rock through this entire journey. I love you, and I couldn't have done it without you. Lastly, thank you, Mom and Dad, for your endless support and prayers.
Tanya Silva. Juan, Dylan, Kyle, and besties, thank you for putting up with my nerves, stress, doubts, and craziness. You all had faith in me when I didn't. It is by the grace of God I have all of you and my new career. I am blessed to have you all.
A.V. Sylvester. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Mom, for your love and support and allowing me to live with you free 99. Noelle, thank you for encouraging me to stick with nursing after 6 career changes. Nee and Yesenia, I love you. I couldn't have made it without you. Let's go get a massage.
Natasha Tenen. To my fiance Eli, Mom, Brandon, Grandma Nellie, Rosie, and my nursing friends, I truly couldn't have done it without each and every one of you. Thank you for believing in me and supporting me every step of the way. I love you all, and so the adventure begins.
Jane Tuku. I give all the glory to God for the grace to go through nursing school. I thank my family for supporting me and being patient when I needed help. Thanks for my professors for encouraging me to stay on. I'm grateful to join those before me to save lives.
Anai Villegas. I would like to thank my family, boyfriend, and my clinical group this past year. You all have been nothing but supportive, and with the help of you, I have made it this far. Love you guys.
Emily Yu. I would like to take this opportunity to thank myself for not giving up, thank my classmates for their support, and thank my professors for their outstanding teaching. Congratulations, class of
22. Thank you, professors. Thank you, Director Simmental. Thank you, Dean Stanskis. At this time, we would now like to welcome Professor Kim Gowell to the stage to lead us in the Nightingale Pledge.
Wow. Welcome. Will the graduating RN class please stand? Yes. I would like to invite all RNs in the audience to stand and join us in reciting the Nightingale Pledge. Repeat after me. I solemnly pledge myself before God. And in the presence of this assembly. To pass my life in purity. And to practice my profession faithfully. I will abstain from whatever is deleterious and mischievous. And will not take or knowingly administer any harmful drug. I will do all in my power to maintain and elevate the standard of my profession. And will hold in confidence all personal matters committed to my keeping. And all family affairs coming to my knowledge. In the practice of my profession. With loyalty will I endeavor to aid the physicians in their work and devote myself to the welfare of those committed to my care. Thank you. Congratulations.
Thank you, Professor Gowell. You guys are hooked now. You said the words. We were all here. We heard you. You're in it now. I'm just kidding. Congratulations, guys. So, yeah, you guys can sit. Yeah. So as we come to the completion of our ceremony, it's very sad, I know. We ask that you please remain seated and refrain from obstructing the aisles so that our graduates and faculty can safely exit the auditorium. Please join me one last time in welcoming back the wonderful Director Simmental for the official presentation of our graduating class.
Okay, I can't let you go yet. The last day of the academic year is really May 25th, so who is in charge of those balls? I want to know, and now. No, I'm kidding. But seriously, nursing school was pretty tough, right? A lot of rules and regulations. But it doesn't end here. You will always be in the professional role. So carry yourselves proudly. And remember, you are always representing San Bernardino Valley College. So be Valley sharp, as Professor Hill always says, and never forget Valley College. I urge you to continue your education, and as many have already said, come back, because we need replacement. I need to be replaced. Our wonderful faculty, we don't last forever, but we need new faculty. But never forget where you came from and represent Valley College proudly. Be good graduates, smart graduates, ask lots of questions, and learn. Learn every day. So it is my honor to present to you the graduating class of spring 2022.
Thank you.
ourselves.